now on CRN Radio, it's time for Silver Moments with Dr. Marcia Baltimore. And now, here's Dr. Baltimore.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Dr. Baltimore. Thank you for listening in. I have a gentleman here with me who really knows how to think about change in America. His name is Jim Truher, and he's chairman of the network called Superwire, which is an internet hardware system that goes all over the world, and which he is backing because it's the future of our communication system. Do you agree with that, Mr. Truher?
Yeah, thank you. Nice to be here, Marcia.
You're welcome.
Superwire provides telephone, television, and internet service at Leisure World and Seal Beach.
And that's a test drive. We're going to go from there to other places, right?
Someday. In time, given the opportunities, we'd certainly do that.
That's fine. Now, I wanted to talk about you a little bit. You told me before you were a president of the Society of TV Engineering, and we can't get to base one in this room without Joe, the engineer. So you must have been doing this a long time.
Well, that was about in the 1968 time frame in Los Angeles. The original Society of Television Engineers was established in the 1940s. And
wow.
I was involved in, I worked for AT&T, and we provided the transmission of television signals all over the country and all over the world back in those days.
So you made the country talk to itself.
That's right. And I've
That's
always
wonderful.
Felt the telecommunications business is a way for mankind to get to know each other.
Well, they're working on it. They're not totally finished introducing, but they're getting there.
Right.
Now, last night we watched President Obama, and it's time for resolutions now. It's January, New Year. And I heard a lot of goals by the president. I heard to create a next generation of citizens through education, to prevent gun violence in the United States, to give diplomats and armed forces a fair chance of working their magic if they can, to standardize the healthcare program in some way, and to insource rather than outsource American business, because 98% of all new businesses in America are outsourced. Those are a few things I heard the president talk about. And I'm just wondering how you felt about all those things. To me, the most important event to me, because I'm a mother and a grandma, was the birth of the baby in England. Now that baby is going to be trained to be a king. We don't train our children to be a king. We train our children to be cooperative to each other and to figure out how they can make things happen so everybody gets a share that's close but not really all together as equal. And you can't take that away from the people who earn it. So I was just wondering if you thought about 003, could you think of anything that you would mark as future changing? And maybe you could tell us what your thoughts would be, because if you were thinking about Superwire in 1960, you surely must be thinking about what's going on now in 2010.
Right.
I wondered where we're going.
Well, we all wonder where we're going.
What
I have believed for a long, long time is one of the most important things is for people to talk to each other and communicate.
Oh, that's what why you're in Superwire. That's what we do.
That's what I've been doing all my life.
As a matter of fact, I'm so proud of this program because the people here at Leisure World are all over 55, or you cannot buy in here.
That's right.
You have to present your birth certificate to buy a place inside of here to prove you're over 55. So when you think about that, we have to get to a place where people respect us. And what we're doing here is an example of it. We've had all kinds of professions on this program, all above 55, talking about what they did before and what they're going to still do. I wrote two books after I was 55.
So, yeah, 55 is a youngster.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm in my 80th year.
Good for you. And you're buying another business. You bought it.
Well, that was 10 years ago. We started Superwire about 10 years ago.
Well, even at 70s, you had a faith in it.
Well,
the
that's
communication
right.
system is in your blood.
Well, what we thought we could do here is show the way with the senior citizens of how to provide a complete communication system at reasonable cost to the people using it.
Right.
And that's what we've done for
the
last
10 years. And then they want to hear what they want to think about. All of our guests so far this year were over 55. One of them climbed a mountain, remember? She climbed a mountain. Another one, like I said, I wrote two books. A third one, it was a minister, traveled all over the world to spread the gospel, but on the way around, he met many people, and he brought good cheer to them. Can you remember any others that we should talk about? I can't get it.
How to cook.
Uh-huh.
Economically. How to reduce the cost of cooking.
Oh, yeah, she was good. We had a cookbook editor. She knew how to reduce the cost of cooking. That's right.
We had a person who was kind to the veterans and gave them free turkey dinner here in Leisure World.
That's right. That's Joe, our engineer. Without him, we couldn't be here. That's true. We did have a dinner for the veterans, especially the senior veterans, and they were very happy we did that. We honored the ones who had honorable mention, and we all had dinner together in one of our clubhouses. So we try to communicate with the communication system that we live in. Now, I was just wondering about Obama's speech last night. I felt it was not quite a resolution speech with peppered resolutions here, there, and there. It was more a goal speech. I think what he was trying to say were the goals he wanted Americans to think about, but not the resolution. The resolution comes a little bit later, and he needs the Congress. He can't do it alone. They have to pass it for him. However, last night he was saying the ordinary people can do it with each other. I picked that up. Was I wrong or right?
No, I think that he's right, that everybody can participate in trying to achieve goals. I think they were excellent goals. I think much of the problem we have in this country is the fact that the people in Congress and the executive branch and the courts are not all on the same page for what the objectives are. And until that happens, till people can agree where they want to head, it's very hard to get there.
Right. They have to set out what the goal is, and then they have to resolve how to get to the goal. There's two steps to that.
That's right.
And the resolve is harder than the goal itself. Because you can say, like I said before, I wanted to know the name of the town on the Ronald Reagan Freeway where this master office of ours, Superwire,
right.
is located.
Right.
I couldn't get it out of my retrieval system in my own head. The minute I looked at a map, the map itself triggered Sunland.
Right.
And the word came out.
That's
now
right.
That's what happens when you're triggering something. You get the goal, which the president sprayed out there last night. Lots of goals. He had many.
Right.
And then after you get the goal, it will hook itself up to the method, which is the resolution.
Right.
So we can try to do that with our country. I don't know. I think we can go through our legislators. I had an idea, for example, because I used to write law for the union, UTLA. It was called UTLA, United Teachers of Los Angeles. Okay, and so I wrote that stuff because I was thinking about it. And last night when the president talked, I had an idea and I wrote it. And I'm going to send it to the union for another bill. That's moving it.
Right.
Do you ever do that? I mean, you must do that. How you could not do that with what you did with buying the Superwire. So how do you come to the steps? First, I want to do this. I want to have communication happen, right?
Right.
And then, how is it going to happen? And then where do you go?
Well, a lot of that depends on your resources, I think. We were in a position at the time that this came up. We had a small company that was doing some other things, and the opportunity to do this is something I wanted to be involved in all my life.
Oh, it was latent. It wasn't tomorrow I'll do it.
No. To me, it doesn't come that way.
No.
And so we started out about 10 years ago here, and signed an agreement here at Leisure World, and partnered with Time Warner, who does a lot of the hard work here for us, and we signed a long-term contract with Leisure World, and here we are. This is one of the things that we're doing.
That's very good. So, what the president said last night, he didn't talk about goals and communication. I read what he talked about. The armed forces, the healthcare system, the outsourcing of American business, gun violence, and presenting to the world a next generation of citizens. That's more like schooling. So if you had to go to the Society of TV Engineering and give a speech, what would you tell them about radio engineering in the future? Is it going to be more important, less important? Is it going to change? How is it going to change? How would you phrase that?
Well, I think I would say it's going to continue to be very important.
Okay, that's
and,
good.
Radio, television of all kinds, all types of communications.
Okay.
Electronic communications are going to be important. And what we really need to do is be sure that everybody in the world has access to it.
Very good.
So that, and that's really happened with cell phones. There are now, today, there are more cell phones by far than there are landline phones, regular old phones. There are almost as many cell phones in the world as there are people in the world.
But really?
Many, many people have more than one, so there are probably...
They average out to be more.
Yeah, there's probably 2 or 3 billion people that don't have cell phones. I don't know, but...
if they give them away...
That's just
the
very first small step. The big step is that people can all see television, and someday we're going to have 3D television, three-dimensional TV. And... That will be coming, but the main thing is for people all over the world to get to know other people all over the world.
I think that's a good way to state it. Very good. And there's one radio television program, that the fellow does nothing but eat in different countries. He runs around and eats. But while he's eating, he's telling you the customs of the people and the food that they grow, that they eat, is in their own land.
Uh-huh.
They go outside and pick it, and then they cook it in savory sauces and so on. And I thought that was very interesting, because the way to your man is through his it's through his tummy.
Right.
I thought that was a very good way to think about it. Food items. We'll be back. Think of a question you want for us and call us at 800-436-2225. Any question you would like to ask, 800-436-2225.
Actually, Marcia, the number is 336-2225. That's 1-800-336-2225. And we'll come back with more of Silver Moments, broadcasting live from Leisure World in Seal Beach, California. Today, we're talking about Superwire Telecom.
You're listening to Silver Moments with Dr. Marcia Baltimore.
Ladies and gentlemen, the number again correctly. Sorry, I didn't catch that. 800-336-2225. Once again, 800-336-2225. And you can ask us anything you wish. And I want to tell you about Mr. Jim Truher, who was the president of Superwire.
He was a football player when he was a young man, and liked to work in the huddle, I bet.
Yes.
And we just now discussed the Oregon team has a new kind of a huddle. Their huddle isn't the old way. And what it does, it limits how the game is played in overtimes. Could you tell us about that?
Well, it was a very creative set up by the coach of the Oregon team, where he eliminated the time spent in the huddle by having a no-huddle offense. So they were able to call more plays during the game, a lot more plays, and get a lot more action on the offense.
All right, so it freed the action, freed the team to act.
That's right.
All right, and how do they control the time?
By not having a huddle.
Oh. So how do they know what they're going to do next?
Well, they have signals. They
All right,
had
so
signs
they
on the sidelines and lots of signals and words, and special secret words they use, everybody listens to.
So they're not secret anymore.
Well, but people don't know what they mean.
Oh, not yet, but they'll figure it out.
And if you watch the Super Bowl, Manning, the quarterback, has a special word that he uses, and nobody knows what it means.
Really?
What is that word?
I don't know. I don't.
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
Omaha.
All right.
That's Denver.
That's Denver.
Right, right.
Okay, so people are using communication rather than body language to get the next step. The football players are using communication.
Right, right.
Rather than body
language. We all have to communicate with each other so that we don't fight.
That's what they're doing with signals. That's very interesting. And are they winning? With that method, are they winning more games?
Oh, yes. Oh,
okay,
yes.
They are. So
oh, yes.
It's paying off. Whatever they're doing, it's working.
That's right.
Okay. Now, I wanted to talk about something else that the president said about goals. He didn't make a goal about it, but he said 98% of the business that is new in America is going overseas, and we have to change it. Now, radio is a good source to figure that out as a method of changing, because it's going to go all over America. So therefore, if you look at the businesses and you look at what we're doing, we have a way to change it. Radio would be the way.
Well, it'd be one of them.
One of them.
What we have in America is access and experts in technology,
mm-hmm.
probably better than anywhere else in the world, even
right.
though other countries are coming along. And if we use our technology intelligently, we'll be able to draw back a lot of
business.
Jobs and business into America.
And probably they would be able to add the technology factor to the product.
That's right.
So there'll be a lot of jobs for techies.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think we're onto something. So the people in the tech schools will probably be onto it faster than we are, and they'll train the youngsters to do that.
That's right. We have to count on the younger generation to solve the problems that we've created.
Well, I think this is not a problem. This is a challenge. The use of communication skills to increase international business this direction into the United States.
Right.
That is a communication problem, and it can be solved that way, I think.
Right.
So somebody will come up with all of that. Now, we have another problem here, which is the high fuel emission standards of our carbon pollution. So we have higher fuel emission standards with carbon than any other nation on Earth. So what do we have to do about it?
Well, I think we're leading the way in reducing carbon emissions around the world. What we have to do, continue to do that, and urge all the other countries to follow suit.
So the word urge implies to me you got to have a radio. That's how you're going to urge.
There you go. There you go. You have to communicate. Uh-huh.
That's right. So you have to have those guys on the radio and say, let's make a team, let's get together, people from Europe, South America, wherever you're from.
Okay, Marcia, we're headed on into a break, and we do happen to have a call for you. You and your guest at 1-800-336-2225. You're
That's right.
With Silver Moments, broadcasting from Seal Beach, California, Leisure World, California. Right here, CRM Digital Talk Radio.
Go ahead.
Now, back to Silver Moments with Dr. Marcia Baltimore.
Thank you for coming back here, people. We enjoy you. Let's hear the question, the first question. Do we have it?
My name is Frank.
Hi, Frank. What's your question?
And I have a question for your guest, Jim.
Thank you.
Hi.
How do you do it? I'd like to know what type of offerings did you have on your cable selection? What type of network? What type of channels?
The number of channels on our network?
Yeah, and the networks that you guys carry.
73.
73 channels. However, the network, we partner with Time Warner. We provide a full array of channels in our partnership, and I don't know the number, but it's in the many hundreds.
Oh, boy. Do you know if you carry the Fox Business Channel?
Yes.
Yes.
I'd like business program.
I'm sorry?
I'd like the business programming.
Yes. Yeah. A lot of good programs out there. We provide full service in partnership with Time Warner. Everything that they provide, we provide. And what we do differently at Superwire is that we manage the service offering in its total. And by doing that, we control the prices. And we're able to offer a segment of service that is lower priced, focused on the retirement communities. And the services that we provide are directed to the senior citizens in the country right now. I turned out, by the time I got to do this, I became a senior citizen. So I kind of understand the kind of things that we need to be offering. And so it's kind of a very special situation here. You can buy a basic television setup for about 77 channels for $24 a month, which is pretty unheard of in America today.
And that's a good price.
We do that intentionally. But you can buy the whole array of all services that we offer, and you pay a lot of money for it. If you're able
I hate to stereotype, but is it fair to say that a lot of senior citizens can get priced out of cable television?
I missed that.
He asked if the possible many senior citizens can get priced out of cable television.
Oh, that's happening a lot, and it's a sad situation. And I have always I worked for AT&T for 30 years, and I've always believed that the prices can be reduced considerably. But you have to balance the need for these companies want profits and high pay, and customers have to pay those bills, and so you have to balance that. So we approach this on a totally balanced basis, where we consider the customers, the employees, and the providers. Try to bring them into balance rather than setting out as profit is the number one priority. All the priorities are equal with us.
It sounds like the Time Warner company has an understanding of your situation with the senior citizen community.
I'm sorry?
Yes, Time Warner, he said, seems to have an understanding of the relationship between your company and the senior community.
Yes, we communicate vociferously with them to be sure they do understand what we're trying to do here.
If anything was to ever happen with Time Warner, would the situation remain the same?
I'm sorry, say again?
Say it again.
If anything was to happen with Time Warner Cable, would your situation remain the same?
I would imagine it's under the contract.
Well, yes, in that our contract continues on with Leisure World here at Seal Beach. We would have to, if Time Warner went out of business, we would have to find another provider for the services, and it would be multiple providers, and we would have to negotiate, as we did with Time Warner, to be sure that there is an option in the services for lower prices.
I don't know if you know the answer to my question, but is there any kind of restriction on satellite dish at Leisure World? Because it seems that some of those satellite dishes can be quite obtrusive. They're an eyesore in certain instances, yeah. And the cable TV is much more accommodating, I think, to kind of keeping things clean.
Yeah, there are restrictions with a satellite dish, and one of the advantages of cable is going to go all the way fiber, all the way to the home eventually, and the bandwidth will allow enormous capabilities that we don't have yet.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much for your service and the good work that you're doing there at Leisure World. It sounds magnificent.
Thank you.
So the bandwidth will increase the services? Will enable the increasement of the services?
The fiber.
The bandwidth.
Yes, of course.
Okay. And that'll come soon? How soon?
Well, it's been happening over time as we move forward. It's, in my lifetime, it's gone from one to billions.
Wow. That's a lot.
Yeah, there are gigabit services in Austin, Texas, planned right now. Gigabit.
Right.
Gigabit.
Not megabit. Gigabit.
What do we have here? Megabit?
Well, we have gigabit service here in part, a little bit.
What is a gigabit service? How do you define that?
That's a trillion bytes.
1 trillion is a gigabit. Wow. Okay, I wanted to talk about something else that is of interest to the seniors, and everybody needs to know about it. The federal government is making new rules for senior drivers. And this was in Twitter. On where do I have a day here? I don't see it. 12/08, yes, December. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration is making an announcement that there's a new 5-year strategic plan to improve safety for elderly drivers. Why? Since 2003, the population of older adults defined as age 65 and older has increased by 20%, that said 20, and the number of licensed older drivers has increased by 21% to 35 million drivers in 2012, according to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. Now they're driving, and how are they driving? Here's what it says. The NHTCH, the Traffic Safety Administration, reported that 5,560 people older than 65 died and 214,000 were injured in car crashes. That's a 3% spike in fatalities in that year of 12. That since 2011 is a 3% spike and a 16% spike in the 1 year, a 3% spike in the fatalities themselves. So there's a problem. We got more people driving, more people killing each other, and more people hurt. The data collection for which the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration wants to refine the system studies physical, cognitive, and perceptual changes with the drivers as they age. Drivers. So what do we know from that? At-risk drivers, functional changes such as vision, strength, flexibility, and cognition are studied. And now they're having Awareness Week, and they're going to tell you their results. They encourage the state highway officers to work closely with the driver officials and the medical providers to share their information with the elderly. What do you think of that? That's the federal government.
Well, it's good. I think the thing that we have to do as far as technology is concerned is continue pursuing the ability of automobiles to recognize hazardous conditions. And some of the new automobiles now put on the brakes when there's a hazard. Yeah, and as that develops over time, we'll be better off.
And probably taking the lessons from the same organization, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. And I notice AARP gives lessons. AARP. They give lessons.
Right, right. And communications is all a part of all of this. You need communications to see, for the vehicles to see and to react.
Mm-hmm. The driver has to react, though, not the car, yet.
Right, today. Today, as it
the driver still has to do the acting or
that's
reacting.
Right. That's right. We have technology now that talks to the driver, that warns them of impending peril.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's excellent. That is excellent. Well, the feds are on it. That's a federal organization I read about to you, which I found on Twitter.
Uh-huh.
So that's a very good thing that they're doing. Now, we're talking about older people and driving, and some older people don't get the privilege of driving. And if there's a caregiver in the home, if you have the caregiver driving, you have to insure that person. I don't think that's a good idea, but that's my opinion.
That we insure them? Or that we have them drive.
That we have them drive.
I understand that.
Yeah. Yeah, I think if you need a caregiver, you have to stay home.
That's right. That's right.
That's what I think. But that's just my opinion. And let's talk about the caregiver for a minute. That's an important role that is being managed by people that are strangers to the person who's being cared for, right?
Yes.
So what does the caregiver have to do? Above all, take care of herself or himself.
Because well,
if the
over
caregiver isn't careful, the whole concept goes into the wastebasket.
Right. Over time, the people get to know each other. We have that situation at our home.
And that's what you want to do. You want to invest time and energy in the caregiver, to invest time and energy in your mother, your wife, whoever it is that they're caring for, so that the loved person has a reality about the caregiver and the caregiver doesn't burn out, because the caregiver could get exhausted, or you as the person being cared for can get exhausted unknowingly. So you don't want to run into that. So rest is what I'm talking about, really. And now, where did I get this? Orange County Aging Council.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They have an aging council. It says, your mother is a caregiver, and so now what? You see? You have to watch how she helps your mother and give her time to rest for herself. It won't work any other way. If she gets overtired, you might as well not have her. So you have to arrange all of that and do your checkups. And they have a list in this issue on the aging, a big long list of behaviors that the caregiver has to know. That's a big responsibility.
Oh, yeah. Yes, it is.
Uh-huh. So when you have a family meeting, for example, do you include the caregiver? Does your loved one have an advanced care health directive someplace? I have a refrigerator door with a magnet, and it says, see drawer 2 for caregiver, for my will, whatever. Because I figure everybody be in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
So it just sits there, and they can go find stuff when they want it. So here they're recommending a big binder with medical history established in it. If you have a medical instruction, the little girl who recently lost her life and her unborn baby's life did not have an instruction for her death, for her body care. And that kept the mother on machinery and the baby connected inside the mother on the same machinery until a judge had to take them off. That's pretty sad. And with a stroke of the pen, it could have been avoided.
Right, right.
So that kind of thing is on your kitchen wall or your refrigerator wall. That's an advanced health care directive and a binder if you want to go to that level, to the name of the physician, the phone number, what kind of a physician, and so on. So let the kids know where you keep it, and then that's the end of it. You don't have to discuss it anymore.
Yeah, that's right? Good. Great. Right.
Yeah. So I thought people are interested in caregivers and interested in instructions have to have their wishes accomplished, and that's how you do it. You just do it and stick the notice somewhere so the kids will find it.
Right, right.
Or tell one kid if he or she is the executor. You can keep this copy. I'm sealing it. You don't open it till the undertaker gives it to you.
That's right.
And that's it.
Another channel for communicating with people.
Yeah, that's right. We don't put it on the radio.
Right.
So, okay, that's it. And I hope we helped you seniors with your needs in life today.
Okay, we have one more segment to go here on Silver Moments, broadcasting today from Seal Beach, California, and Pleasure World. We'll come back with much more to come right here on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
The number here is 800-336-2225.
Once again, 800-336-2225. Now, we have our own little newspaper inside of Leisure World, and it has events and changes that you might want to know. We do this at the end of every program. The first thing I want to talk to you, Mr. Truher, is what kind of changes will they be making in Superwire that we should know about?
Okay. I'd like to talk about that. Superwire has been here at Leisure World for about 10 years. And what we're attempting to do is provide a service the residents don't pay any additional for because we participate in revenue with Time Warner. And that pays our cost for doing business. And what we provide, we have employees. We have 8 employees here on site in our own office. And we handle all the calls and billing questions that they might have with regard to all the services that we provide, which include the telephone, internet, and television services. And our staff has become pretty expert, and they're all folks who live here at Leisure World, so they understand the senior conditions that we deal with. And we fix things like remote controls and little things like that, and we've been doing that for a long period of time. And it seems to be working very well. We've been able to keep the price of the services down below the average out there in the world outside the gates here. And that's our attempt to show the world that that can be done. And seniors, and myself included, at times run into new technologies that we don't have time to figure out how it all works. We need a little help. And even though I've been in the business a lot of years, more than I care to count, I need help myself periodically. So anyway, that's the kind of thing that we're doing here. And keeping the balance between the business and the employees and the customers is one of our primary goals.
That you're succeeding in your goals. Yeah, I mean, you're doing them.
Well, that's what we're trying to do, mm-hmm. trying to keep it up for, trying to show that
maybe
this can be done all over the country.
Resolution, break it down to a little bit, and it'll work by 1 year. Can
yeah,
you do that?
Well, we'd like to see what we're doing expanded all over the country.
There you go. Expand. Well, why don't you use your radio?
There you go.
Tell them all about it.
That's what they need to know. It's happening.
Well, that's right.
And the radio is the method.
That's right.
At least all over the U.S.
That can work anywhere.
Yeah, and then you use the internet to the rest of the world, right?
Uh-huh, that's right.
I got a fan letter once from Melbourne.
Is that right?
Uh-huh.
That's right.
For CRN. Well, you know, this is connected to CRN.
That's right.
I started over there, CRN. Well, I want to read you some of the ads from the Golden Ray newspaper, Seal Beach, which is our in-house paper. We are having an election for the board of directors of this particular community. Vote. Go and vote.
15 seconds.
15 seconds, you can vote. And our thanks to Les Cohn, the ombudsman of our community, to the Congress.